you'll be fine. Is it? It's okay. Yesterday, I explained you about the history first lesson, that is Vijayanagara Empire Part 2. Okay? Day before yesterday, I explained you about Vijayanagara Empire Part 1. I've already sent you the classwork also. I think you have all completed the notes. Is it? So now, I am going to start with the civics first lesson, our constitution. Civics first lesson, our constitution. Okay? In this lesson, you are going to learn about the meanings, importance, salient features, then preamble to constitution, then drafting of the constitution. Alright children? Yes. First, meaning. What do you mean by constitution? Okay, first of all, you should know what do you mean by constitution. Okay, constitution, it is the basic set of written rules. Okay, basic set of written rules. Okay, rules, structure, outlines, duties, rights, functions are explained in the constitution. Understood? Yes, it is the supreme law. It is the supreme law. The constitution is found to be in the democratic country. As you all know, our India is a democratic country. So that is the meaning. It is a set of basic written rules. Okay? Constitution. The rules and regulation that has to be followed by every citizen. Understood? Yes. Now, the constitution, it is a guide to the government. It is a guide to the government. No one should violate the rules and regulation that has been written in the constitution. Okay. All the people, including the Prime Minister, the Chief Minister, or the parliamentarian people or the citizen, whoever it is, should obey the rules and regulation that has been written in the constitution. Understood, children? So, meaning and importance, that is very important. The constitution, it protects the rights of the citizen and it functions as a reference guide to the duties to be performed by the government. Then, it coordinates the functions of the democratic institution such as legislature, judiciary and executive. Okay, so now we come to know about the drafting of the constitution. Drafting of the constitution, that is the constitution assembly, it is prepared. That is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as its president when the assembly met for the first time. First time when the assembly was met, at that time Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the president. Okay? Now next it is, they with 299 members in the Constituent Assembly. The first session took place, that is the first session, it took place on 9th, okay, December 9, 1946. Okay, that precisely took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to finally make our constitution. Previously it took out 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. Okay, to complete the constitution, to make it final. Okay, so now what is the need to frame constitution? I'll tell you a simple example. When you are playing football, football is having certain rules and regulation. Football, you are not supposed to hold it in your hand. Will you hold it in your hand? No, it is a wrong game. You have to kick in your leg. That is only football. And next example, when you are coming to school, you have to come with your uniform. Other than uniform, you cannot come by your own. The schools are having sets of rules. You are You cannot write your own question and you cannot write your own answer. Okay, the same way the constitution is also the same. It is a written constitution. Talk about the drafting committee. Okay, the constituent assembly prepared the constitution. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as its president when the assembly met for the first time. Dr. Rajendra Prasad, he was appointed as the president of the, when the assembly met for the first time. There were 299 members. There were 299 members. 299 members in the constituent assembly. The first session, that is, when was the first session started? That is, constituent assembly for the first time on December 9, 1946. First time was at, on December 9th, 1946. Okay, it took precisely 2 years 11 months and 18 days. It took 2 years 11 months and 18 days to finally make our constitution. Okay, what is the need for framing constitution? What is the need? Suppose, I'll tell you some one example. Suppose you are playing football. Okay, when you are playing football, it has to be played with your leg. Rather than you cannot catch it in your hand. That game will be a foul game. Next, when you come to school, you'll have to come with your full uniform. You cannot come as you like. See, there is also a set of rules that a student has to be followed in school. And when is examination? When I talk about examination, what are the questions are given? According to the questions only you are supposed to answer. When you are writing exam, what are the questions given? Only the according to the question you have to answer. Other than that, you will fail if you write your own answers, is it? You cannot do that. What is given, to that only you have to answer. That is the rules, okay? So, according to that only you have to write. Okay, now, the adopted on, the constitution was adopted on January 26, 1950. But it declared India as a republic on 26 January 1950. Okay, every year 26 January is marked as Republic Day and it is a national festival. You all know, when you come to first standard itself, you will come to know 26 January. If I tell what is 26 January, you will all tell that it is a Republic Day. Okay, so now on November 26, every year the Constitutional Day is celebrated in the country. Understood? So now, next it is the preamble. Okay? Preamble to the constitution. When I was talking about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was the law minister of India. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was the law minister of India from 15th August 1947 to 26 January 1950. Okay? He was the law minister of India. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Okay? From 15th August 1947 to 26th January 1950. Understood? So now, according to that, the parliament with bicameral legislature, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, came into force in 1952. Understood? 1952. The Constitution of India, it contains 395 articles. How many articles? 395 articles and 12 schedules. Okay? 12 schedules. Next, we are going to talk about the preamble to the Constitution. Preamble to the Constitution. As you all know, the preamble is said to be the heart. It is the heart of the Constitution. Okay? It is the heart of the Constitution as it presents the ideologies. What all? The ideologies, the dream of the people, justice, freedom, liberty, equality, fraternity and national integrity. Everything is mentioned. In the previous edition, in India to constitute India into a sovereign, okay, sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. So this is the introduction of preamble. Okay, it is the introduction of preamble. A preamble talks like that. What is sovereign? Sovereign is what? What do you mean by sovereign? Sovereign is India is independent both internally and externally. Both internally and externally, India is independent, where she can frame her own policy. She can do her own policy, her own rules and regulation. It is not under anybody, any other country's control. So that is only called as sovereign. Next it is socialist. Okay, it seeks to reduce the gap between the rich and poor. It safeguards and protects the interest of the poor and weaker section. Next it is secular. Secular, what do you mean by secular state? Secular state means it does not promote any particular religion. It does not promote any particular religion. It treats all the citizens equal, irrespective of the religion faith. So all the religions are given the equal status in our country. That is why the preamble tells that it is a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic. As you all know, India is a democratic country. What do you mean by democratic? Democratic means it is the government by the people, for the people, and to the people. Okay? It is the people's government. It is governed by the people. It is governed to the people. And it is governed for the people. That is only democratic. Then finally, it is a republic. What do you mean by republic? Republic means India shall have an elected person as the head of the state. Elected person should be the head of the state. There is no king's rule or queen's rule. It is the people, the elected people. The elected people represent the country. Okay, there is rule, representatives. Okay, in which this kind of political system is known as a democratic republic. Understood? And moreover, our constitution, it is a written constitution. In the beginning itself, I told you, a salient feature. That is written constitution. The Indian constitution is in the written form. It is the lengthiest constitution. It is the lengthiest constitution. The structure, power, and extent of the constitution of the three organs of the government, that is the executive, judiciary, and the legislature. All the executive power, the legislative power, and the judiciary power, everything is written in the constitution. There is a single constitution both for central as well as state government. Therefore, the size of the constitution is very big. So that is, the written constitution is also the lengthiest constitution. Understood? So India is a written constitution. It is the lengthiest constitution. Okay, so now I told you about sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. Okay, I told you all that. So, what are fundamental rights? It is the rights of very much essential. Fundamental rights are very essential for the development of individual personality and also for the collective good. So, as you all know, fundamental rights, I will explain it to you in the later on classes. The coming classes, I will explain you about the fundamental rights. So now, so far what you are studying, that is constitution. When did it come into frame? What is the results of the constitution? Socialist means what? Then secular means what? Then democratic means what? So everything I have explained you in detail. Try to understand. Okay? You have to understand and read that, write that. Constitution. Okay, when was the constitution framed? Who was the framer? Who was the lawmaker? Okay, next, independent judiciary. The decision of the Supreme Court is final. all are expected to obey it. Okay, that is only independent judiciary. The judiciary is independent of executive and legislative. Okay, next you have the universal adult franchise. What do you mean by universal adult franchise? The system of electing representatives. The system of electing representatives through voting of adult members, that is 18 years and above. You should be 18 years and above, then it is called as universal adult franchise. All citizens are eligible for voting without any discrimination. Okay, if you are a citizen of India, you can vote if you are above 18 years. Understood? So, a state which sets a goal to provide social and economic security. Okay, what is a welfare state? What do you mean by welfare state? Welfare state is nothing but a state which sets a goal to provide social and economic security to all its citizens. It's generally known as a welfare state. Welfare, doing good to the people, to the society. That is only called as welfare state. Now, election system. Election system. India is the largest democracy, you know, is it? Populated. So, next it is election system. You know, is it? Every year you go for election along with your father and mother. Now you are not aged. Okay. When you come to 18 years, you also can come in your parents for election. So India is the largest democracy in the world. In the past 6 decades, periodical elections are being conducted. Okay. So the system of democracy has been adequately deep-rooted in our country. People are elected through elections. Okay. The representatives are elected through elections. Okay, it is still a satisfactory system in spite of certain demerits also. Okay, so I think this will be the lesson explanation about our constitution. Okay, what do you mean by drafting committee? A new word, that is the committee that prepared a draft constitution and placed in the constituent assembly for discussion and approval. Understood? In general, what is constitution means? It is nothing but a set of written rules and regulations that has to be followed by every citizen of the country. Whether you are a prime minister, whether you are a chief minister, or whether you are a MLA, MP, or whether you are a parliamentarian, whoever it is, you are supposed to follow the rules and regulations that has been written in the constitution. Understood? Everybody should follow the rules and regulations. So, I told you the constitution was adopted on January 26, 1950. The constitution declared India as republic. Okay, in order to make this, every year January 26 is marked as a republic day. Understood? I told you the preamble. Preamble is the art of the constitution. Preamble is the art of the constitution. In preamble we talk about that is, and tell that is democratic justice, okay? Justice, equality, fraternity, and what all is coming. See, justice. What is justice? All the people should be getting equal justice. Everybody should be under equally. They should be treated equally. Okay, equally they should be treated. Then equality. There should not be any discrimination. There should not be any discrimination between people on the basis of gender, color, caste, or creed. It should be equality. Then fraternity. Fraternity means it is the feeling of brotherhood. It is the feeling of brotherhood which aims of removing social barriers. It should remove the social barriers between person to person. That is only fraternity. Okay? The preamble of the constitution tells us all that. justice, liberty, equality, fraternity, social, secular, republic, democratic. All these are the preamble to the constitution. The preamble of the constitution, it is the art of the constitution. Alright children, did you all understand what I explained? Constitution. It is a very, very important thing. Though it is executive, judiciary or legislative, whatever it is, everything should be come under the constitution. So children, I am sending you the notes of this lesson. Copy the notes and then I am sending you the homeworks also. Try to complete the homework and send it to me. Okay children, don't waste your time. Time is very precious. Alright. So now I will be sending you the notes. Okay children. And moreover, I think you have completed the history lesson notes. That is Vijayanagara Empire. But you didn't send me the homework. I asked you to send me the artworks homework, but nobody has sent me. I'll be noting the names. I told you when you are sending in the WhatsApp, you send your name. You just mention who is that, who is writing the homework. So that I will entry, I will do the entry. Okay. So start writing the homework as well as complete the notes. Okay, children. Thank you.